Hello, everyone.
Hi there.
And welcome back to another episode of What to Watch with Antony. This is episode 9, and I'm so happy to be joined again by my wonderful grandmother, Mary Gili. Thanks for coming back.
Thank you very much.
Yes.
It's a pleasure.
Yes, and today we have a great episode for you where we will be suggesting 5 great films, all based on books. Do you do a lot of reading, Nanna?
Some reading, yes.
Some reading. Mm-hmm. But you've seen a lot of these movies we're going to talk about.
Yes, absolutely.
All right, so our first pick of the day is a film called The Help. Change
your thoughts. It's quite scandalous. Sounds like Jackson, if you ask me.
You tell Abilene.
Do I have plans for her?
You a godless woman. We going done it now.
Nanna, have you seen The Help?
I did see The Help. I saw it twice.
Twice, and you don't see movies like repeatedly. That was special.
Not just like that.
Yeah. So The Help was a 2011 film directed by Tate Taylor and follows Emma Stone in the lead role as somebody who, you know, is a writer and wants to showcase what's truly happening to the people that in this, her town where she lives, are the maids, the African-American maids, and what happens to them, and really tell their story. It's a very moving film that features a great performance from Viola Davis and also Octavia Spencer, who plays one of the maids, and she actually won Best Supporting Actress for her role in this film. It's a really great film. It definitely has a lot of funny moments.
funny.
Definitely has a lot of funny moments. So if you haven't seen this one or it's been a while, check it out. It's a great, nice little matinee film.
I found it very exciting too.
Yes, exciting. But don't eat dessert while you have this film. It won't be as appetizing.
No.
All right, the second film we're going to be talking about is called Hugo.
A secret.
What is that? I think it's a message from my father.
Why would my key fit into your father's machine?
To finding his way home.
This is a treacherous place, do you understand? Watch your step.
We could get into trouble. That's how you know it's an adventure.
You've tried to forget the past for so long. Maybe it's time to try and remember.
The story's not over yet.
This Thanksgiving, Academy Award-winning director Martin Scorsese invites you on an incredible journey.
Stop that child! Apprehend!
Once upon a time, I met a boy named Hugo Cabret. He searched to find a secret message.
I need to know what this means.
And how that message lit his way. All the way home.
This is another 2011 film directed by Martin Scorsese. But before you think this is a gangster shoot-em-up film, this is actually based on a very, very beautiful book, The Invention of Hugo Cabret by Brian Selznick, and follows this young boy who's, after his father and uncle pass away, he lives by himself in the walls of the Paris train station, and he fixes all the clocks in the train station. And it's about his friendship that he has with a young girl who visits the train station regularly, and a toy maker who lives in the shop. And it's a beautiful film about discovering your purpose and making friendships. And also, it is really inspired by the work of Georges Méliès, who made some classic films like A Trip to the Moon, 1902's Trip to the Moon, one of the first films to use color. So if you're into classic, and I mean classic films, this is such a beautiful, just elegant film that is great for kids too. It's I know, a Scorsese movie for kids. It is. It's a really lush, beautiful film. What do you say about this movie? You saw this movie recently.
Yes, this movie, I saw it. It was amazing. What I liked about how they put in the story ended up into the old movies, the 20s.
Mm-hmm.
It was amazing
how
it intricate in each other.
It's a good story.
It was beautiful. Mm-hmm. And it was fun to see the actual clock inside. I love that too.
Yeah, you really get up close to the clocks, and it also has a great cast. Ben Kingsley, Sacha Baron Cohen.
Yeah, he's my favorite actor.
Yeah.
One of my favorite actors. Mm-hmm.
All right, the third pick we have for you today is a 2019 film called Jojo Rabbit.
I tell on you, you'll be in big trouble.
They'll never win.
Love is the strongest thing in the world.
Your mother took me in. She's kind. She treats me like a person.
You two seem to be getting on well.
She doesn't seem like a bad person.
I'm the enemy.
You're not a Nazi, Jojo. You're a 10-year-old kid who likes dressing up in a funny uniform and wants to be part of a club.
This is from writer-director Taika Waititi. His script for this film won him Best Adapted Screenplay at the 2020 Oscars. And it follows a young boy named Jojo, who is a Hitler youth near the end of World War II. And it's about when his mother, played wonderfully by Scarlett Johansson, takes in a young Jewish girl. Learning about the Jewish culture and learning about this young girl and developing new feelings, changing his thoughts on morality. And it's a really interesting film, a very funny film. Another thing that's really intriguing about the film is that Jojo's imaginary friend is Adolf Hitler, played by the writer-director Taika Waititi. So it's very much in line with the classic works of Charlie Chaplin with The Great Dictator, also Mel Brooks. And if you didn't catch this one in theaters, make sure you catch it. It has such a big heart, this film. It's truly one of the greatest comedies, one of the greatest comedies that stand among the work of Mel Brooks and Charlie Chaplin. What about you, Nanda? You like this movie a lot.
Well, you say it's comedy. Mm-hmm. I see a little sadness and serious in it too.
Yes, it definitely
but the
has
comedy,
a balance.
The comedy had to balance
the drama.
The things that people went through, mm-hmm. Second World War, and especially mm-hmm. Hitler.
Yes.
So, mm-hmm. It did happen. It was very touching, and mm-hmm. I enjoyed it tremendously.
And Scarlett Johansson was good, right?
Absolutely.
Yes.
That's my special word.
That is your special word. The fourth pick we have for you today is a 2018 film that broke box office records, broke records just on its own for being one of the first, if not the first, studio films to have a completely Asian cast. And that is Crazy Rich
Girl. I fell in love and I want to marry her. You're Nicholas Young. You're untouchable. But Rachel's not.
Have you prepped Rachel to face the wolves? You know I'm back, like I never left. I really admire you. It takes guts coming all the way over here, facing Nick's family. Another day, another breath.
I know this much. You will never be enough.
Yo, it's about time someone stood up to Auntie Eleanor. Well, you, not me. Oh, God. She can't know I was ever here. I feel glorious, glorious. Got a chance to
start again. I was born for this, born for this. Ever since I can remember, my family has been my whole life. Rachel! Rachel!
If Nick chose me, he would lose his family. And if he chose his family, he might spend the rest of his life resenting you.
You nasty, you kinda nasty, you got nastier. Glorious,
glorious. Is a young woman who is engaged to her boyfriend and finally meets his family and realizing they're one of the richest families in Singapore. And it's her journey to try and show his family that, you know, she's important, that she doesn't need to come from this background to truly be one of them. And also about the family, specifically the boyfriend's mother to be more accepting of that. It has a lot of great costumes and a lot of great sets to see how all these people live. It has a really, it has a lot of great scenes, great cast, and it did, it broke ground in the summer of 2018 for how trendsetting it was when it came to its Asian cast. What do you think about this, Nanda?
I saw it. I enjoyed it for the costumes. Mm-hmm. The costume designs were nice, and the places chosen.
Yeah.
Was beautiful, beautiful, very beautiful. Scenery. Very pleasant.
Yeah. Very, it's
very
a,
pleasant.
It's a lot of fun. It was nominated at the Golden Globes for Best Picture, Musical or Comedy, and also Best Actress, Musical or Comedy. So check this one out if you missed it. It's a good one. All right. And then the fifth and last one is a personal favorite of my grandmother. I have not seen this, so it's all going to be about her. Nanda, what movie are you talking about today?
We're talking about the movie of Richard Chamberlain. He, in the film that was series on television for, I don't remember how many weeks, Thornberry.
Will you come back?
Father, Daddy, and Stewie. They're dead.
Maggie. It's not too late for Maggie. Look after Maggie. Don't forget her. It's time.
I'm going to marry Luke O'Neill.
Where's Maggie?
Just a beautiful story. It was taken in Australia. Acting was superb by all the actors. Some sadness, but that happens when you are a big family and you struggle with life and you know, nature. And it made me feel that while watching it, made me feel like I was there. I was part of them, whatever places they went.
Thanks. All right, so that's it for us today. Thank you so much for watching. We'll be back next week, maybe not my grandmother, but thank you so much for joining us again today. Hopefully we can do this again sometime. Let us know if you watch any of these films and then if you enjoyed them, and we'll see you soon. Bye, everyone. Stay safe.
Cheers.
Cheerio.